Welcome to this video on Bluegreen deployment with Apache and Docker. In a typical Bluegreen deployment scenario, you have two instances of your application running in production as identically as possible, called a blue and a green deployment. A reverse proxy then forwards the user requests to either the blue or the green application instance, which allows you to update the inactive instance without your users noticing, and then switching the traffic to the updated version of your application, again without any downtimes. In this scenario, we have two applications that use the same database. Therefore, you can simply switch between the two application versions, but still have the same data source for both applications. So what's the motivation behind this? We want to minimize application downtime during deployments. Ideally, we want to have a zero downtime deployment where each user request is handled by a working application. And also we are aiming for rapid rollbacks. In this video, I will show you how to spin up two Docker instances that could represent your applications, and configure Apache as a reverse proxy to switch traffic between those two instances. The good thing is that no additional tools other than Apache and Docker and no services are required for this deployment. So it's really easy to make something like this happen in your current application. Let's get started. As already mentioned, we are going to use Apache as a reverse proxy, and we're going to use two Docker instances of nginx as our application instances. For simplicity reasons, we do not use a database here, but it would be straightforward to configure applications to just use the host database. So let's get started. I have just reinstalled a cloud instance on vulture.com with CentOS 8, and we are now going to SSH into that machine to get started. So I will copy the IP address, SSH root at IP address, and copy the password from the interface. So we are now in a completely blank CentOS 8 instance, and at first I will have to cheat and install Docker Community Edition with these three lines. And once that is done, we have a working Docker and can verify that it works by running systemctl start docker. All right, the Docker service is now started, and if we run docker ps, we can see that there are no containers running in the moment. Now we will make two directories in /tmp named blue and green, and those two directories will contain the source code of our application, and spoiler alert, it will consist of a single HTML file. So let's echo blue works to temp blue index.html and green works to temp green index.html. All right, you probably guessed it. We will now launch two Docker containers with nginx that will use those two index.html files and run on port 8080 and 8081. And those two containers will represent our actual web applications. So we run docker run with a port mapping of 8080 on the host to 80 on the Docker guest. We will name the container nginx-blue and create a volume mapping from temp blue into user share nginx html with read-only. Since Docker does not already have the nginx image, it will download it. Once the container has been started, we will launch another one with almost the same parameters, but we will use port 8081 on the host, name it nginx green, and map it to the green directory. And we can now verify that both containers are running by running docker ps, and we can see that there is an nginx image running on port 8081 named nginx-green, and an nginx image running on port 8080 named nginx-blue. So we can make sure that both applications are running smoothly by using curl localhost 8080, and it will respond with the blueworks output. And if we query the 8081 port, the greenworks output is shown. Now, for the next part of the tutorial, we will install Apache and configure it as a reverse proxy. So if you remember, we said in the beginning that we need to direct the traffic to one of the two applications, and Apache will allow us to do just that. So install httpd with yum. We stop the firewalld, which would normally prevent our 80 port to be exposed. So by default, CentOS 8 comes with SE Linux, and SE Linux would prevent Apache from initiating outbound connections, thereby making it unable to proxy requests to another port. We need to disable this setting. So let's run user sbin setsebool -p httpd can network connect and set it to true. Once this command has been run, we can now create a new config file in /etc httpd conf.d, and let's name it reverseproxy.conf. This is a config file for Apache, and we will create a new virtual host listening on port 80. And we tell Apache that all incoming requests on port 80 should actually be passed to port 8080. Let's save. And we can now restart httpd. And we will find that incoming requests on port 80 are now redirected to our blue deployment. For the next step to demonstrate how to switch between those deployments, I will open another terminal window and connect again to the same server with the password. And I will now instruct bash to curl localhost 80 and sleep for 1 second in an endless loop. So as you can see, we are now making requests each second, and we will get a response from our reverse proxy. Now, if I restart httpd, you can see that there is one request that is refused while Apache is restarted. Good news, we can avoid that. We can just say systemctl reload httpd, which will not lead to timeouts. So if we now edit the configuration file that we created previously, we can now simply change the port and reload httpd. And voila, you see the green deployment is now used. And we can also switch back quite easily by just doing the reverse. So this is how you can do a very simple blue-green deployment using Docker and Apache.